International Airport. Please be sure your seats are in their upright position, your tray table stowed, and your seatbelts fastened. Please take this opportunity to turn off anything that rings, beeps, or twitters. We should be at the gate in just a few minutes. Welcome to Miami. Thank you for choosing Pan Am.
News. Even Mr. Handwriting only knows his half of it.
This is against everything the FBI stands for!
I know. Isn't it beautiful?
Yes,
Felicia.
Felicia.
received 1961, New Rochelle, New York. I got a present that changed my life. I already had the two best parents a kid could possibly have. We weren't like other families. We were the Abingdons. My dad said we were like one of those window displays on Fifth Avenue at Christmas time. Everybody else was outside, pressing the nose against the glass, wanting to be us.
You know what I found on the sidewalk, Mademoiselle? It must have slipped right off your neck.
Frank, we can't afford this. If the IRS finds out, you'll be in more trouble than you already are.
Merry Christmas, Paul.
They caught my eye. I didn't expect you to buy them.
Never say no to the woman you love, Frank. She only comes along once in a lifetime. Don't ever let her down. No. I ever tell you the story of how your mother and I met?
Told me about a million times.
It was Christmas Eve, right after liberation. France was crazy for anything American.
I love a man in uniform.
A man is his uniform, Frank. I was a private, filled you with mud, but for your mother, I was a conquering hero. I took one look at her, she was dancing. Said,
I will not leave France without this woman.
And I didn't. Of all those GIs, I was the one who took her home. Didn't speak a word of French. 6 weeks later, she was my wife.
The dandon needs my attention in the kitchen. I give cook the night off.
He still takes my breath away every damn time.
Daddy, what's the IRS?
An organization devoted to making everyone else's life miserable.
Are you in some kind of trouble with the store? Because I don't need to go to private school.
Don't listen to your mother. She gets nervous. We'll be just fine. Two little mice fell in a bucket of cream.
I know the story.
Then you know what happens.
Well, the first mouse gave up and drowned.
And that was the end of him.
But the second mouse wouldn't quit.
What'd he do?
Well, he eventually churned that cream into butter and crawled out.
And who are we?
The second mouse. Mouses. Mice.
Yes. And don't you forget it. Everything will be just fine. Merry Christmas, son. My father gave me my first checkbook. You know what he called it? My passport to the world. I never looked at a comic book again.
Frank Abagnale, Jr.
But no address. It's classier that way. I think Nelson Rockefeller puts his address on his personal checks. No way, Jose.
How cool is that?
Like much when you first hold them. Nothing special to the touch, but look inside. Every digit points the way. Every date's your lucky day. Every check's a winning magic carpet ride. Your heart and mind, there ain't nothing you can't do. Cause you got 50 choices, 50 chances, cool hot cash or hot romances. 50 chances can make those dreams come true. 50 chances don't look like much, but listen, Frankie. Lock. your mother in the kitchen, whether she needs it or not. Paula.
Everybody said my mom was the most beautiful woman in New Rochelle. What happened next wasn't my dad's fault. Sometimes I think it was my fault for coming home early that day. Mom, I'm home. First day wasn't so bad. And why didn't you tell me that co-ed meant girls? And they got mice, a much nicer gym than St. Louis.
Frankie, you know Mr. Butz, your father's insurance agent.
What's he doing here?
I was trying to interest your mother in a new policy, son.
My father isn't here. Get out, Frank.
It's all right, Paula. I was just leaving.
Don't judge me, Frankie. There are things between a man and a wife you won't find in your comic books. I am not Wonder Woman. Your father is not The Flash.
My father? Loves you.
He loves a person who doesn't exist. She never did. Your father and I are both at fault. We'll be better apart.
He won't let you go. He'll make you stay.
Oh, should that dog, Norbert Leo Butz.
Speak English.
I adore you, my little dreamer.
Then don't go.
I'm sorry, Frankie. Je fais mon mieux.
You said speak English.
Go to your room. Jack Barnes.
Jesus, Paul.
Keep your voice down.
When were you going to tell me? My own son knew before I
did. I didn't expect it to happen. It just did.
You're going to make me the laughing stock in Rochelle. You know that, don't you? Business wasn't bad enough. Who's going to come into the store after
that's
this?
That's not my concern.
What is your concern? Not me or our son.
I am tired of the fighting, your drinking, of living beyond our means.
There's no flowers. There's no. There's no Steve McQueen. Tell me, make my way escape. How can I fly like a hero in the sky? Be a shooting star out in the stratosphere. Where's the shadow?
Yeah.
to the world. One way to New York City.
Well, Prince Chief,
I'm not coming back. Will you take a check?
It won't bounce.
See, I'm sorry, Mr. Norton.
How did you know my name?
Your name tag. The New York, New Haven, and Hartford needs conscientious workers like you. Which track did you say it was?
Four.
Thank you!
Nelson Rockefeller, hey!
Down the street, run out of town. I'm gonna run from the boys. You ain't never touched down. Run from the folks, cause it's all been fake. I'm gonna run from the choices that I've done one day. It's not out, I can't wait. It's the perfect time to graduate today. I'm gonna run away now. I'm gonna run away, oh yeah, yeah. And we'll see the truth when I move on. They'll need each other much more once I'm flush and he's back on the street. I'll pick him up and ride down Easy Street. He turned to cry for all the years. The rusty gas tank full of tears. Get you nowhere. Not the places I want in.
Traveler's checks are in the suitcase that American Airlines lost.
Same thing happened to me.
What? These are golden. I want manufacturer's handover calls, a preferred customer.
Well, I wish I could help you, but even if you were a writer for Holiday Magazine...
Damn. Isn't that obvious? I was trying to be suave. No, this is my first assignment for them. I'm writing a story about New York's friendliest hotels.
Aren't you...
Aren't I what?
Young to be a travel writer.
What have you got against young people?
They travel.
They need a place to sleep. But we're not welcome here. Is that what you want me to write?
I didn't mean that.
That's how it came out. People, listen. Russell, now, what's your max?
200.
100 will be just fine.
There's no name on this.
You think Nelson Rockefeller puts his name on his checks? It's classier that way.
I'm having trouble making out your signature, but Mr.
Barnes. Jack Barnes.
Well, hey, welcome to the Big Apple, Mr. Barnes.
So far, so good. Live and living color. Something special's up tonight. Though I'm live and living color. At the FBI, the show's in black and
so anyway, to make a long story short, we're having turkey for Christmas dinner. I was just trying to expand your taste buds, she tells me. They don't need no expanding, I tell her. Normal people don't eat goose.
FBI.
The lower depths.
Is Carl handwriting Merry Christmas?
Oh, that's who your child's fault. She puts him up to it. What was wrong with American food? Nothing till she came along. You open a can of tuna, chop some onions and celery, add mayo, mix them all together, and voila! Home cuisine! I hate public television.
Me too. All they do is talk.
Who asked you, Agent Dollar? Did I ask you? Did Agent Bratton ask you? Did anyone in this building ask you? Did anyone on this whole goddamn planet ask you?
No, sir.
Shut up and stop being a wise guy.
Leave the kid alone.
We're only having some fun with him, Carl. We always give the rookies a hard time. And don't you remember how they razzed you?
Yes, and it is an experience that I see no reason to repeat. Agent Dollar, I want you to check out every name on this list for even the slightest infraction of the law. I mean speeding tickets, I mean parking violations, I mean everything.
That's gonna take all day.
I don't care if it takes all night. We're gonna catch this guy. It's our job. I don't care if we like it, period. End of story. What do you think you were signing up for, huh? TV show? Okay, all right, listen. I know that there are times when this job lacks a certain, excitement quotient.
Times? You means every day, kid.
Days you can't get up from behind your desk, there's so much paperwork. Weeks without a lead in the case. Months at dead ends. Years of coming up empty-handed. Time will seem to stop. Nobody will know we're down here. What are you doing? Come on, except him. The guy you're after. Oh, he knows, he knows. He's the reason you plot on. The day you catch him, and you will, makes everything worthwhile.
I can't wait to nail one of these bastards.
Listen, I personally had the privilege of covering a major league investor right there on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange and escorting him in cuffs out of the building into a waiting police car. Now, that was the proudest moment of my life.
I would have shot him.
Listen, later that day, I had a phone call from our director. He said he heard good things about me. I said, that's funny, Mr. Hoover. I heard good things about you too, sir. Yeah, he didn't get it and hung up on me. Okay, that's enough of an epiphany. Agent Cobb, I want an update on that Newark paper hammer. And Agent Brenton, if you could bestir yourself to answer the ringing phone.
I was having an epiphany of my own. Your words were so touching. Brenton.
Oh, this is how I like it. Everyone's at work. Making America safe from paper hangers. Welcome to Carl Hamrady's personal salt mines. No shiny suits or fancy cars, no open tabs at uptown bars. Don't press the flesh with movie stars, that's not my cup of tea. No charge accounts at fancy stores, my name won't open any doors. No big ups since the Punic Wars, but that's alright with me. Cause here I am to save the day. Never know it from I got LA. My name won't ring a bell to you. At least I know I'm good at what I do. If you're looking for wild car chases, big shootouts, and women who look like Angie Dickinson, you're gonna be sadly disappointed.
Guns and fast cars are why I joined the FBI.
Once, maybe just maybe, in a blue moon, and probably not even then, a car chase and a shootout, but Angie Dickinson, never. No penthouse views or ice cream, no Playboy bunnies on my phone. When centerfolds, I'm home alone, just me, myself, and I. Then I wake and turn the lock, I hit the road and punch the clock. A mother sheep among the flock to lead the battle cry. Up here I am to save the day. A burning itch that will not go away. So most I'm special agent ill. But Jesus Christ, I'm good at what I do.
Hey, Ray, can you ever loosen up?
Absolutely. Every time I collar one of these SOEs, I plot. But until then, I am one tight asshole.
Monday. Merry Christmas, Mr. Hanratty, sir.
Jim.
Jack Barnes, $100, $275, $121.75.
Chicken feed, come on! Come on,
give me something I can sink my teeth into. They say that all I know is work. Well, I am my job, it's not some quirk. I'm FBI, not petty clerk.
You won't hear me complain, because I'm not one to sit in line. I don't need place cards when I die. A turkey sandwich sits me fine, this desk is my domain. And here I am to save the day. No burning hits that will not go away. To most I'm special agent Hill. But bet your ass I'm good at what I'm... Jack Barnes. Nelson Rockefeller? Fella, you just got interesting.
Get out! This is a hotel! Not a flop house! And my call, NBC, they never heard of you.
Cashing random, anonymous, bad checks is not a way of life. I needed an identity. A phony one, albeit. I found my inspiration on the same corner where they pulled Marilyn Monroe's skirt overhead when I was in grade school. A piece of Manhattan that would make any young man's sap rise.
Taxi! Taxi! Oh, thank you, young man.
I never met a cab, I couldn't stop.
What are you, a professional taxi getter?
Right now, I'm the doorman in the past most exclusive dance club.
Not the Peppermint Lounge.
I'm not allowed to say. That's how exclusive it is.
Oh my God, it is! Guess what? He's the doorman at the Peppermint Lounge.
We've been trying to get in that place for months.
I suppose I can be persuaded to put you on the list. Hey, we're not talking Howard Johnson's here. That might get you into the Rainbow Room, but... that should do it.
Yeah, we'll be there. Wait till we tell our friends we're in with the doorman at the Peppermint Lounge.
Oh, yeah, that's a really cool uniform. My dad always said a man is his uniform.
No, your dad's right. I was nothing until I put this on.
I love a man in uniform. I love him out of it, too.
But you know the Pan Am's hiring?
Well, they must be. They took me. Oh. You thinking of being a pilot when you grow up? It's a great life. Thrills, chills, world-class cities. The perks are pretty obvious.
It's the only way to go.
Here, Frank Taylor. He's in personnel. Talk to him. Hey, don't quit your job until you get us in.
So long, anonymity. Hello, Penny.
And I just don't feel at home in mine, so I'll slip.
Suddenly my mind is full of stewardesses and how fast I can get myself into a Pan Am pilot's uniform. I don't want to fly planes. I want to meet girls.
Woke up in Brooklyn with a frown upon my face. Just left Wisconsin where there's cheese enough to start this rat race. All thanks to the Brothers Rye. We don't know where we'll sleep tonight. Yeah, I'm a bird in the sky.
School paper, Mr. Taylor. about the Pan Am pilot.
You get your Pan Am's future. Fire away.
Where's his uniform made, for example?
We have someone on 7th Avenue makes them for us.
I would love to interview him, too.
This promises to be a very detailed article, young man.
I want to know everything short of actually flying the plane. No details too obscure. What's that badge wearing, for example?
It's just my Pan Am ID. We all wear one. You can't go to the bathroom without one.
Can I get a copy of that for my article?
You can have mine. It's 3 years out of date. Doesn't mean they all want them.
Thank you, Mr. Taylor.
Call me Frank.
I'm Frank, too.
Woke up this morning, kissed the wife and kids goodbye. I had one for the road, so that's why I call this flight the red eye.
Air France is a thick, pleasant, and first sight of my landing gear. When I touch down inside her room, the gold can feel the salt.
I'm a perfect 38 regular, right off the rack. But you're kind of young to be a pilot. I get that a lot. I'm just a co-pilot.
Why don't you take two, just in case?
Good thinking. Will you take my personal check, Sammy?
Why don't I just bill Pan Am directly like I do for the other pilots?
Save them reimbursing you.
Even better!
Would you like the sleigh ride or lady ride? It'll just lay home but if you want jet set.
One of the reasons. Have you ever shot anyone into handwriting, sir?
Yeah, but I made sure I missed.
This isn't just target practice for you, Hanratty. You're working something out.
Don't start with the psychobabble bullshit.
Just putting it out there, Carl. Believe it or not, some of us actually like you.
All right, I'll get which one.
Put the gun out and we'll tell you.
I'm listening.
You're taking this case too seriously.
He has cashed over $200,000 in bad checks in 6 months. We don't even have a lead on him. Huh? One day he's in Dallas, the next he's in Stuttgart. This guy's a Mexican jumping bean.
Calm down, Carl. It's not cool.
Nobody ever said I was cool.
The kid says he's caught you sleeping in the office at least twice.
Judas!
I'm worried about you, sir, that's all. Were you always like this?
I mean, I was born this way. How else do you explain it? Other kids wanted to play cops and robbers, I only wanted to play cops. It starts very early, once the baby toys are gone. A kid on the playground has to choose what side he's on. It's the bullies or the good guys, boy, there ain't no middle ground. Hoodlums try to blur the line and twist the truth around. Then they call themselves a winner, but they're self-deceiving fools. Cause the game ain't worth winning if you're breaking all the rules. The law is laid upon us when, as kids, we first ask why. Our parents sent the rules when, cause I said so, they reply. And though I thought I hated them and screamed with all my might, the next time that I had a choice, gee whiz, I did what's right. No, I never snuck a drink, I never stole a pack of coups. Cause the game ain't worth winning if you're breaking all the rules.
Don't break the rules,
or else we're living in the wild, wild west.
Don't break the rules.
Got to keep a scar. You don't want to fail that test.
Don't break the rules.
You thumb your nose right at the life for which I strive.
But those rules, those laws, keep us alive.
We started back with Moses when he led around the Jews.
The Jews.
And climbed way up that mountain to pick up God's daily
news.
Well, he slept up on Mount Sinai, cried, and they don't dare.
Sure,
would fire.
You can give away those jewels.
or criminal forger to apprehend. It's amazing what these nose-to-the-grindstone guys can come up with when his spirit moves them. On this show, everyone sings and dances. When a pilot flies for free, it's called deadhead. I was getting very good at it. When he runs into Miss November in his hotel lobby, it's called I Can't Believe This Is Happening to Me. We all had Cheryl Ann's picture in our lockers in high school. She was our goddess. I asked her for her autograph. She asked me up to her room. I thought it was for an autograph. She thought it was for something else. We both found out it was for a crash course in economics. Hers and mine.
How much are you willing to spend?
On an autograph.
On me. All night. Go on, Frankie. Make me an offer.
$300?
You're cute. I like a man with a good sense of humor.
$500?
You're obviously not a Wharton graduate. Let me explain the word capitalism to you. The man who would suggest that the best things in life are all free, he never met me. The gent who thinks a rose is a rose proves he just doesn't know. You reap what you sow. You're one.
Even better.
So He writes bad checks.
Not the mine, the bounce. He's in 135, he's the king.
Hey. What's he look like?
Who could tell? He's always wearing those goddamn Doc Aviator glasses, and I got...
I thought my kid's room was a mess.
Looks like Mr. Taylor left in a hurry.
You can tell a lot about a man from the way he leaves a room. Mr. Taylor has left us a gold mine. Go ahead, gentlemen. Dazzle me.
Yeah, a man likes company. It's French. All the way from Paris. Je suis impressed.
He likes comic books, especially The Flash.
Did you see last month's issue where he was tied up in this giant squid?
Sorry, sir.
He's not a gourmet. Looks like he lives on pizza and peanut butter.
He likes women with humongous tits. Check out this July.
This March had bigger tits than that.
The hell she did.
No way.
Let me see. Oh, the greatest tits of all time were Miss November 1959. Hands down, they were...
Come on, hey! I want to hear some deductions.
He likes junk food.
He reads comic books. He has a breast fetish.
He's a slob.
Oh my God, it's handwriting!
Well, you bozos are cracking yourselves up. The single biggest piece of evidence is right in front of you. A man's secrets are in his trash.
Gross. I draw the line at going through garbage.
So you go find the maid, see what she knows.
Alrighty, when was the last time you had a home-cooked meal?
I do not remember. He's in here somewhere.
Hey, do you ever consider looking at your own life for a change, not somebody else's? What are you turning into?
Agent Grant, please, I'm trying to work.
Come on, he wants to be alone. Genius at work.
I hope you had your shots, Hanratty.
No, wait a minute. Something is not jiving. Comic books, peanut butter, maybe he's got a kid. My life is just fine, Mr. Taylor. Let's see about yours. Some comic books, a Miss July, a matchbook from the flame, some chewing gum, a mismatched pair of shoes. Letter home wasn't mailed, a check without a name. Yeah, that'll be my guide to the man inside the clue.
This is Mr. Taylor in 135 room service. How are you this evening?
I'm very glad to hear that. I just flew in from Amsterdam. Not Amsterdam. Have you been there? They got these girls in windows. Sure. I'll hold.
Bobby pins, two baseball cards, some day-old Chinese food, two ticket stubs, the Red Sox always lose. A Valentine wasn't sent, a cent to set the mood, when I take a ride with the man inside the clue.
A company for President's body. And President and Mrs. Johnson. They will be met by White House officials, including his brother, Robert, Attorney General.
Do not disturb is on the door. The maid, she never comes. He locked the door, but I don't need a key. There's only garbage on the floor. To others, they're just crumbs. Those crumbs look like a five-course meal to me.
Hello?
Who is it? I think it's him again. Frankie, are you there?
I use my head to get in his, so I can think like him. I see he flies, and also cries the blues. But if I look at my own life, I'm out here on a limb. Yeah, it's best to hide, see the man inside the clue. As a pilot for Pan Am, my family gets to fly for free. I'm taking us all to Acapulco. We fly
wife for Pan Am and he's married with kids. Well, it's a start, Mr. Taylor.
I've looked into so many lives, but never at my own. The trail I left is such a damn cliche. Things you threw away. Like a front door key, a home cooked meal, the happy bride and groom, then life kicks in, makes you pay your dues. And then you're fired, you're by yourself. A single motel room that's been occupied by the man inside.
Sorry, maintenance.
A room. The blues.
Burn out. god.
I'm trying to stop my eyes out.
Service out. Dollar, take the stairs.
FBI! becomes electric.
They're calling it the golf ball.
You just pop out the old ball, pop in a new. He's way ahead of the game.
Don't move, put your hands in your head or I will shoot.
He's got about 200 checks here, a gallon of India ink, draft envelope. He even makes little paper envelopes addressed to himself from Pan Am.
Now keep your hands where I can see them.
Relax, buddy. You're late. Name's Allen. Barry Allen, United States Secret Service. Your boy just tried to climb out the window. My partner has him in custody downstairs.
What are you talking about? Keep your hands up!
You think the FBI are the only ones tracking this guy? He's been dabbling in government checks. We've been following a paper trail for months. We almost had him in New York. Then in a motel outside D.C. the Dulles Airport. You mind taking that gun out of my face? It makes me nervous.
Let me see some identification.
Here, take my whole wallet. You want my gun too?
I didn't expect Secret Service on this.
Don't worry about it. What's your name anyway?
Hanratty. Carl Hanratty.
Mind if I see a badge, Carl?
Yeah.
Can't be too careful these days.
Yeah, sure. Here's some more. Brand new too.
Tough luck, Carl. 5 minutes earlier, you would have landed yourself a pretty good collar.
Oh, that's okay. 10 seconds later, and you'd have been shot. Hey, let me ask you something. What did he look like?
He's a handsome son of a bitch.
I had him figured for an older guy.
He is pretty damn old. He's got to be your age, at least.
Okay, I had that coming.
Hey, do me a favor. Call it a professional courtesy for up here. Sit tight a minute. I get some of this evidence downstairs.
Right, yeah.
I don't want anybody walking through my crime scene.
Yeah.
Some maid comes in and starts making a bet. I hate when that happens.
Yeah, me too.
What are these things?
Yeah, it's an MICR encoder.
This guy, he thought of everything.
Wait. I've seen you before.
It's possible.
No, I never forget a face.
Me either.
I'll come over.
I'm sure you will. In the meantime, this thing's getting kind of heavy.
Yeah. Oh, Agent Allen, your wallet.
It's Barry. Please. Hang on to it until I come back for the rest of this stuff. I trust you.
You shouldn't. That was a joke.
You got me, Carl. Ah! I'm trying to track you down. Merry Christmas.
It's him.
Put a trace on this!
Maryland Secret Service, what do you want?
I want to apologize for what happened out in Los Angeles.
Yes, screw you.
Carl, I'm sorry.
God damn it! Don't you feel sorry for me!
The fact is, I knew it was you. No, you know, maybe I didn't pull the trigger, but I knew.
People only know what you tell them.
And tell me something. How did you know I wouldn't look in your wallet?
I didn't.
You're gonna get caught. You know that, don't you? One way or another, just like Vegas, the house always wins.
I didn't think I'd get you in. I thought maybe you had a family?
No family.
How come?
Hey, Vinny, you didn't call me to apologize, did you?
What do you mean?
You got nobody else to talk to.
I'm not the one who's working on Christmas Eve.
Hey, I'm not working. I'm at a party.
Woohoo, Carl!
So was I.
All right, you want to talk? Let's talk face to face.
I have to go.
Wait!
What?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Yet don't you love the Yuletide fun? There's joy and cheer for everyone. I wait for Santa with a gun. Yes, Christmas is my favorite time of year.
Sugar plums I haven't kissed, but mistletoe I must resist, 'cause I'm on St. Carl's most wanted list.
Yes, Christmas is my favorite time of year, and there's a home where you can't go, and there's a life that's full of love you used to know. Tveit snow, but keep not you.
'Cause your family's here, yes. They're still yours too.
Oh, if you come from the cold. So if tomorrow Santa's flown, the tree is down and you're alone, I'll still be here, pick up the phone. Yes, Christmas is my favorite time of year.
Look out the window.
Why?